You see that dark, empty corner down there under the table? Well, there's two things that came out of it. First is this Macintosh, which I've shown in a previous video a couple years ago. And then this. Well, not the monitor and all that stuff, just the system unit. This was the last computer that I built myself from scratch, from the case and the drives and the motherboard and everything. After this one, I started going with used compact Despros, like the Despro EN that I've featured in many of my videos. I had one before that, which was a larger desktop compact, which was the computer that replaced this. So I built this around, I'm gonna say around the year 2000. It has a Cyrix CPU in it, and it's interesting how badly this drive has yellowed compared to the rest of the case. And it's not due to exposure to light, because it's been sitting in that corner for most of the past 7 or 8 years, almost. And on the back, you can see it's a full AT kind of a motherboard, so it's not an ATX. They didn't have that. Well, I think they had ATX in the year 2000, but this was the cheapest parts I could find around then. So, there's your serial port mouse, a second serial port, parallel port, video card, and sound card. And it has this nice pass-through to power the monitor. And I did not originally use it with this monitor. I originally used it with this monitor, a 14-inch Arch Super VGA monitor, but since I was too lazy to pull that one out of its hiding place, I just used this one, the monitor I got with my PS2. Model 56, and I just pulled out the most convenient keyboard and mouse and speakers I had on hand. So let's fire it up. You can see it's a Cyrix 686MX, and the amazing thing is I have not used this computer in at least 6 years or so, and it's almost exactly correct on the time and date. It's actually December 9th today, and it's showing December 8th, so that's pretty close. And two hard drives installed. That size indicated for the first hard drive is obviously incorrect, because it's actually a 12 gig drive, and they only allocated 4 digits to show the size in megabytes, so it's overflowing that column there, but it actually recognizes all 12 gigs. So it works correctly with no problems, except just not showing up correctly on the screen here. And the second hard drive is, I guess, 1.2 gigs and 64 megs of RAM. All those options there. There's integrated peripherals on the motherboard, floppy serial parallel, no USB, this is too old for that. And I'll exit without saving. There, it's a PR266, which does not mean 266 megahertz, that means it's comparable in performance to a Pentium 266. Found the CD-ROM. And starting up Windows 98. And let's see if the maritime man can recognize that hard drive sound. That's right, it's a Quantum Bigfoot 5 1/4 inch hard drive. That sound. Okay, let's see. Actually, it has Windows 98 Lite. They're showing the Cyrix M2, 64 megs of RAM, Windows 98 second edition. All the different components. There's a modem. I don't think there's no modem in there. Sound is an ESS 1869. I think I had a better card in there originally. I had a Sound Blaster 16, but I took that out to put in a different computer. Old version of Internet Explorer. Let's see what version that is. Ooh, version 5. Cool edit. This is the program that became Adobe Audition. This is, what is it? Cool edit 1.53. And I have some music tracks on here. I have no idea what this is. Guess we'll find out. Well, evidently it's a rip from a pretty modern CD, judging by how smashed the levels are. Typical hyper compression and clipping and limiting. Let's see what it is.
Baby, set me free from this misery. I can take it no more.
That is BB Mac. Let's see what else is here. Oops. How about this? Oh, Chicago. Well, you would expect that by the name. These are good speakers, actually. Well, enough of a cool edit. QuickTime player. Get QuickTime Pro 5. No thanks. Alright, what do we got? Sample. Yeah, choppy sample video. We also have Nero Smart Start, Windows Media Player, Adobe Acrobat Reader, Exact Audio Copy, Winamp. Let's see what version that is. 5.08. Also some kind of scanning program for an old parallel port scanner I had. Wintune 97. Okay. I think this is some kind of benchmarking program. Let's analyze now. Well, there's some of the results. So it claims a clock rate of 225 megahertz, which I don't really believe. I'll have to check the motherboard settings to see what it's really running at. And different speeds here. Yeah. Well, that doesn't make much sense. Is a T-Sang or Tseng, however you say that, T-Sang Labs ET6000 or 6100 PCI video card. And yeah, it's one other program here that I used to really enjoy using is this medium wave database viewer. This was the database of all the AM radio stations in the Western Hemisphere, last updated January 2000, so it's quite a bit outdated now, but before you can look this information online, you could use this program to download the database from the FCC, and then this would be the interface for it. So you could see things like antenna patterns, and where the transmitter is located, and the power they're using, all the different stations for each frequency. And one neat thing you can do is show the sky wave. Like you can see, this is highlighted in blue, That means you're likely at night to get a good signal from this station via Skywave or Skip, as WBZ, which I do get a very good signal from at night. Yeah, like WTIC 1080. It's also in blue. 1090 WBAL. So, a lot of neat information in here. Well, enough of going through windows. I'm sure you want to see what it looks like inside, so I'll shut it down. And just a simple message there. Now, if you're going to ask me how to get this text mode shutdown message in Windows 98 instead of the usual graphical message, don't, because I totally forgot how I did this. Well, there it is. It has a Super Source power supply. Never heard of that brand. Made in Taiwan. 200 watts. It's a Sony IDE CD-ROM drive. 32x speed. March 1999. And, well, there's the second hard drive. I think that's a Quantum. Not 100% sure, though. Yeah, I didn't even know I put an internal speaker for the sound card in here. So one of these two speakers is the PC speaker. Another speaker is for the sound card. And there's my ghetto CPU fan just velcroed to the video card and just blowing on the CPU heatsink. And just wires plugged into a floppy connector. And, it's one of those cheap PC chips motherboards with a VX Pro chipset. There's the RAM. 72-pin SIMs and also DIMMs, although I just used the 72-pin. There's the version number you always see on PC chips motherboards up by the keyboard connector in the corner there. Oh, I didn't realize it does have a PS2 mouse port. I was using a serial mouse. And there's that battery that's still good. KTS no-name battery. Some UMC chips there. And there's the ESS sound chip. Did not know that had an internal speaker output. There's the BIOS chip. Three 16-bit ISA slots and the rest are PCI. And the one part that's most unique is the most hidden here is that Quantum Bigfoot 5 1/4 inch hard drive. You can just barely see it in that bay there. You can just barely see the sticker on top of that Quantum Bigfoot hard drive. Apparently it was a compact OEM drive. 12 gigs. Okay, let's turn it back on so you can hear that built-in speaker. See how loud it is. No, that's not good. Something rubbing on the fan, I guess. Has a turbo button. Yep, it definitely is a built-in speaker. I also didn't realize that the Bigfoot drive has its own little built-in LED indicator on the drive itself towards the back. It's kind of interesting, in addition to the indicator on the front panel. There it is, playing some music. So, not too bad after all. certainly better than I expected for that little thing. What I want to feel forever. I just noticed this here. You last checked this drive for errors 2,925 days ago. Well, you can divide that by 365 to figure out how many years it's been since I last used this computer.